Are you gonna join in today?
Huh?
We can react to Eurovision.
I've really not done this very well, but welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hello. I know you were following the drama previous. I do have an update for that, which will come very soon, because I have some very good news. But it's cold outside today, it's snowing, and there's not really much to do. So I thought, I've got the dog down in front of me. So if you hear like a clucking or moving, and I've got some food cooking, so I need to be quick. It's him basically moving around, so it's fine. But don't forget to like and subscribe. But today's video, for anyone that knows me, I love Eurovision. I have since I was a kid, basically. But what I have never done is react to videos. So I thought today I could, hello. Just had a little bang, what was that? So today I thought, here we go, Skorzan, ta-da. I thought I'd react to Lithuania's Discotheque by The Roop. Fun fact, I have a degree in theatre arts and musical theatre, and I used to be a dancer and a singer. we stick to child with singing now though. So yeah, it'd be nice to see from a dancer or an old performer's perspective how they've gone about this year, because last year, listen, we were up there, we were out loving life and just my dog's barking. Archie! My dog's barking. But yeah, let's crack on. What I've come to realise though, before I play it, I watched a little bit of it and I like the fact they've done like a little storyline to it. So like, you've gone from On Fire and now you're seeing the backstage thing of going into Discotheque. I like that. Sad life. I hated being backstage with the nerves and adrenaline. You used to stand there like, I've got to repeat this, right? I can't help it. I have a thing for the lead singer. I think he's really attractive. I don't know why. I have a thing for Baltic men. This is like a proper story, isn't it? You can actually see it. Oh, hi. Babe, don't look depressed. Ooh, does the eyebrow thing. I don't like that. I don't know if anyone saw the Cadbury. It's a UK chocolate called Cadbury. They had an advert with the eyebrow. I mean, my eyebrows are shit, but they had a commercial, an advert where the kids' eyebrows are moving. How would you even do that? It makes me go so funny though. It's a good start though. Okay, I feel the rhythm. Oh. Something's going on here. Reminds me of David Bowie. I don't know why. It's something like what David Bowie would kind of do, if you know what I mean. Right, by the way he's going, like, look, he's instantly gone from like this pale blueness to bang, hey bitch, I'm here. It's very David Bowie. Oh, we love a Bilal Hassani reference. My eyes are blinking. I'm blinking with you. My eyes are blinking. I'm going, all right, you're mesmerizing me now. Okay, I gotta stop blinking. Legit me at home when no one's around. The dynamic of this is very, very good. how dynamic they've been. It's very Martha Graham. There's a choreographer called Martha Graham. By the way she does things, it's very like war and like, it's not grotesque, that's the wrong word. It's not what I'm trying to portray. They're not grotesque. But it's very like within yourself, and then you're projecting and things like this. It's basically what they're doing. And it's, yeah, I can see that straight away. And the wedding position is as well. Listen, fun fact, I actually have a yellow suit. I have a yellow suit. I've never worn it. My aunt called me a canary and I never wore it again. So I might have to bring it back out. I mean, I've got high hopes for Lithuania anyway. One of my favourites is still Donny Montell. His voice is just... It's just the Cadbury's advert. It really reminds me. Okay, so the stage in here, I don't know if you can see it, my ring light, but it's very like, hello, beautiful. It's very like Alice in Wonderland, if you know what I mean. It's like a tale. Like, not like a fairy tale, but like a tale. Who's messaged me? Hello, psychic medium. Yeah, it's very like Alice in Wonderland, if you know what I mean. I don't know if that's what they're trying to get across as well. So you're in like this trance of discotheque. When you're, listen, I dance at home alone anyway, when I'm sweeping the floors or I'm washing or when I'm working, I'll have my work phone on me, just like singing and dancing along. I'm just minding my own. So yeah, I get that reference. I 100% get that reference. I will admit though, in their live performance, because I watched the final, and in their performance as well, it's very like boom, 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 and it's so precise. I was gonna say precise then. Wow, bilingual. It's very precise and very clear what they're trying to portray, and I do really, really like that. And I just, at the minute, this is right up my street. I'm a bit weird. I'm not saying they are, but I'm a bit weird with things like that. And yeah. I like that, the way it just cuts off and you can just breathe. I like that a lot. It's very like I feel like I'm tripping out right now, if I'm honest with you. I've never done drugs in my life. Never done drugs in my life, but I feel like I'm tripping out on that bit. Oh, smile babe. Listen, I, for the life of me, I have tried for, oh, I can't do this. Watch his hand. Ha ha, smile babe. Listen, I've got a master. I mean, I've not got nails on. Wait. Throw me in the trash. Laughing at you. Yeah, that. Okay, so I'm here for it and I'm picking it to pieces, but I'm here for it. Like, I absolutely love it. Will it do well in Eurovision? Fuck yes! Of course it will. We love the Roop. I mean, I do anyway. I don't know about you. Projectually, I want to see how that goes on a Eurovision stage. I want to know if they're going to do a bit more. I got a spot. Ignore that, like, trash head. I just want to know if they're going to do more. Like, what more can you do? Like, the song itself is just very like, this is me, this is what we are, you're going to have it, deal with it. We are here for it. And we are here for it. Stage-wise and presence, I mean, I know I dissect it, but that's just me. I was trained to be a bit of a perfectionist. being on West End stages and stuff, you sort of get to see how it's made and things like that, and seeing that and showing, it's like a story, as I said at the beginning, like, it's like a story. So they're going from on fire, my food is burning, so, you know, telling this story of what actually goes on backstage, like they're in a bit of a trance or winding down from adrenaline after being on stage. And I like that a lot, but I really want to see where this goes. Like, out of 10, I'd probably give this a solid 10, if I'm honest with you. But yeah, I'd love to know what you think, because I'm just talking shit. But I used to be a dancer, and I still sing from time to time. I do miss the stage, but I'd love to know your thoughts. I am new to this, so please bear with me. I am just an English person in a Brexit country. Thank you for watching. I'm going to go and get my food now. Well, actually, let me drink this. And take the dog for a walk in the snow. Because my dog's obsessed with snow. But don't forget to like and subscribe. I will probably do Ukraine next, because I've heard mixed reviews about that as well. Any other country you want me to do, please do let me know. See ya.
I'm just here for it.
Good.